Thank you for joining us today. We trust that you will be motivated, challenged, and inspired by this week's message. Let's join Mike now.
Because there's something very significant and extremely powerful about stepping out in faith and not just speaking out in faith. Especially, don't miss this, when we step out before we speak out. I believe the reason the shout out worked was because it was after a step out. So here's the thing. Can I give you a tip today? If you want God's attention, just step out, not just speak up. Let's go back to the walls. So imagine the scene for a moment. They have to circuit these walls, clear instructions, not to shout or even speak. Now, first day, you understand that they will probably be able to achieve this. Anybody can do something on the first day. Oh, let's start a church. First day's easy. Easy. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Because you go out with such expectation, anticipation, and you're thinking God's going to do something because he's just done it. So you've gone through a river opening up, and you're like, well, if God can do that, hey, what are we worried about? First day's always easy. They were still remembering what Joshua told them. Today, they would see a sign that the one true living God was present among them. So they're like, okay, we're still believing for this sign. They've already seen it. But now they've got enough faith to believe that they're going to see another one. And that, just like us, they believed everything was going to happen in 24 hours. They were human beings. And you know, Joshua knew otherwise. But he kept stum. He didn't say a word. I find that interesting. So second day. So nothing happened on the first day. Second day, they must have thought, surely this is the day. Maybe yesterday we missed something. But today is our day. And this is our moment. And now is our time. And I can hear them, you know, reciting things like we do. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens. I was born for such a time as this. God is greater than anything that's going to face me. And if God is for me, who can be? So they went out. And they came back. And God didn't turn up again. Now do that for a day or two. I get it. But 7 days? And remember, we know the end of the story, but they didn't. Every day, they were one step closer to their breakthrough, but they didn't have a clue that they were. And every day was harder than yesterday. And that's when they had to make an intentional choice. Am I going to get discouraged or am I going to stay encouraged? I think that's a good point for a pause. When you don't see God answering your prayer, you don't see words coming to fruition, are you going to stay encouraged or are you going to get discouraged? Your choice. My choice. Because if God is God, it ain't over till it's over. And if he hasn't put over on it, we're still under. His grace and his love and his protection. We're still going through the process and the journey to the miracle. And every day they put their feet on that land, they were treading on their territory and claiming their promise. In other words, and this is powerful, when they left an imprint with the sole of their foot, they were in fact leaving an imprint of faith. Do you know how powerful that is? That when you walk into a word or a promise that God has given you, and you act like it's going to happen, you are leaving an imprint of faith. The reason it's so significant is what I touched on last week, that when we keep walking it out, we're proving that we believe that God's working it out. Work it, work it. That's what God is doing. God is working it. He's working it out as we're walking it out. We don't need to declare it with our mouth. I was amazed when God showed me this, because our actions speak for themselves. We don't need to stand. This is a great opportunity to say, we don't need to stand in our workplace. I don't know whether any of you do, but I mean, some Christians do. They get their Bible out and start reading it. It's like, you know, that's not normal. I don't need to tell you that. I know we've got normal people here, so you don't do that. I don't get why people feel the need to do that. I don't get the reason why sometimes people have to go out with sandwich boards in the high street, with scriptures on, you know, saying doom and gloom things that the world, the end is nigh, and you better get saved, and if you don't, you're going to hell, and all this kind of stuff. Because here's the thing, if we live out this good news, if we live out in faith in our workplace, we don't need to go preaching to anybody, because it's not about the words coming out of our mouth. It's about our actions speaking louder than our words. We need to be Christians, not tell everybody we are. If we got to tell everybody to convince them, they've said it wrong. Because if we are being Christians, they're going to know. And you know, there's going to come a conversation one day and people are going to go, I knew there was something different with you. I knew. Because you do things differently to everybody else. So our actions speak for themselves. Every time we walk it out, we're declaring the power of this. Romans 8:28. We are confident that God is able to orchestrate everything to work towards something good and beautiful when we love him and accept his invitation to live according to his plan. So the more we step out, the more our lives speak up, because it amplifies our faith for all to hear and it exemplifies our trust for all to see. It's powerful. It's powerful. It becomes, let me say, loud and clear. And I believe the main reason that God didn't want these guys to speak was because he wanted their actions to do all the talking. That's why this time was not wasted, because it was not only a preparation time, and that I want to talk about a little bit more next time, but preparation is so important. Don't underestimate the power of preparation. You know, the preparation period is always a long time. It's always a long time. But don't underestimate what God is doing. And don't underestimate what you are showing and proving to God and others in that preparation time. Anybody can do a miracle. Anybody can go through the end result of a miracle. That's easy. That's the celebration time. But can you celebrate on the journey as you're believing for it when it doesn't even look like it's ever going to happen? That's the time we prove our faith. Not when we receive it, but as we're walking towards it. People will laugh at you, ridicule you, think you're crazy, think you're mad, book you in for a few sessions. So that's why this time wasn't wasted, because it wasn't only preparation, it was presentation. It's our preparation for the breakthrough when our lives speak the loudest. So it's in our preparation that our lives speak the loudest. When we could be discouraged, we stay encouraged. When we could be downcast, but we're upbeat. When we could be sad, but we're glad. When we could be snappy, we're happy. Oh, I can feel a dig in the ribs coming on somewhere. Talking to you again. You didn't do it last time. Our lives are, I'm not looking anywhere. I'm looking at my notes and I'm not looking anywhere until I got past this statement. Our lives are always making a statement. And one of the statements we need to make is this, that at some stage, one day always has to become today. It definitely wasn't yesterday, and it might not be tomorrow, but it could just be today. Let's never underestimate the impact of our actions, because they are influencing people way beyond our comprehension. People are watching you. I'm sorry, did I just freak you out? People are watching your life. People are watching my life. People are placing expectations on you and me. Isn't that scary? Do we live up to expectations? Probably not, because I've realized I can't live up to everybody's expectation. Because here's the thing, everybody's got a different expectation of us. Some people want me to drive a certain car. Some people are really ticked off that I drive another car. Some people would have me going around in a Robin Reliant. If you don't know what one of those is, I've just shown my age. It was an old three-wheeler. Some people would have me drive around in a S-Class Mercedes. Some people would say, that's too prosperous to live that way. Others would say, that's too poor. See, the expectations of people, by the way, I don't drive around in either of those cars, a Robin Reliant or, praise God, or a Mercedes S-Class. People want me to dress a certain way. People want me to look a certain way. They have expectations on you. But the only expectations I want to live up to are the expectations that God has put inside of me so that I can be a witness to people, so that they can see faith in my life, and it might just inspire them to have faith in their life. So God is using every step we take and every move we make every day we wake. Your step is your prep. Your step is your prep. And I want to encourage you to keep stepping out. Because there's a reason why one more round is so hard when you've already been round six times already. I know the feeling. You are in good company today if you have been round that mountain so many times, or round that wall, you know, just hoping it would come down, hoping you would get your breakthrough, and you still don't have it. And it's like, Pastor, when am I going to get it? I know. I'm still believing for breakthroughs from 21 years ago. I know what it's like to keep walking around, and it feels like I haven't got the energy to walk around another time, and then I find supernatural energy from somewhere to just go around another time. And do you know why it's so hard on the sixth time to keep going and have the faith for the seventh time? Because of the significance of 7 on 6. I want to leave you with one last thought. Don't miss this. Don't stop on 6. See, day 1 is lots of fun. Day 2 is still too new. Day 3 is very key. Day 4, we're looking for more. Day 5, we barely survive. Day 6, we're in a fix. But day 7 is just like heaven. That was worth a hand clap, because that took a long time to put together. Well, about 5 minutes. So today, keep stepping on, keep stepping up, and keep stepping out, because you are so close to your breakthrough. Something's going to break out for you, and you are going to break through it. And here's the thing, because your one day could be today. And if you give up now, you may never see it. Oh, the amount of people over the years that I've seen give up just when we were about to break through. Things are happening. I know sometimes you can look at it on a Monday and you go, I so appreciated that message yesterday, and I so need it today, because do you know what? I can't see God breaking through in my life and everything I've ever believed for. I'm not, and we start to pile on these words, and that's sometimes why God just says, hey, just shut up, because you're going to just talk yourself out of this. And that's what they would have done. They've been in the wilderness for 40 years. Don't you think that they could talk themselves out of it really easily? And he's like, before you pile on all the negative stuff because he knows the way the enemy works. You start entertaining one negative thought and negative words come out your mouth. It's not long before that whole thing, which was, you know, it's like it becomes a mountain in your life. A molehill becomes a mountain. And what was small suddenly becomes so big. Well, I've never seen God break through. That's not true. And not one person on the planet that can say that. I've never seen God break through in my life. I never see God answer prayers in my life. It's okay for Pastor Lois. She just seems to have a connection to heaven. Faster than broadband. Faster than cable. It's like no sooner a prayer's gone up, they're answered. I know I live with her. Don't you think I get slightly frustrated that I have to wait for mine, but she gets hers answered? And you think, when are we going to get our breakthrough? It's coming. Don't give up now. Don't give up now. Try one more time. Because your one day could be today. And that's good news. So keep on keeping on. And don't stop believing. Don't stop on six. Make sure you get to seven because it's going to be heaven. Let's stand. How many of you want to pray today? Good thing to do, isn't it? By the way, as we're praying, I'm very aware that we reach people on the internet. And as we're praying today, I know that God is going to take this message and calls others to pray with us. Another 72 people in the midst of floodwaters gave their lives to Jesus in Pakistan on Friday night. We're now over 6,000 people in the last 12 months. If that isn't anything short of phenomenal, I don't know what it is. Why our church? Why that message? I don't know. I'm not even going to ask that question, really. God's going, oh, if I told you, you wouldn't understand it. So just trust me. Oh, but that's hard. Just trust it. We'd like a formula here, Lord. Because what we'd like to do is package that and offer it to some other countries and see if we can get another 6,000. And he's like, no, this is supernatural. And if you started doing that, potentially, you might forget that I'm in the midst. Oh, yeah. Okay. It's all happening because of you, isn't it? Let's pray. There might be some people that are watching that have never prayed a prayer like this before and want to give their lives to Jesus. Let's pray these words anyway. Say, Lord, today, thank you for reminding me of the lost key for faith and for the challenge to step out before I speak out. Thank you for reminding me again that without action, my faith is useless. But with action, it's productive. I want to leave my imprint of faith everywhere I tread, with everyone I meet, in every place I go. So as I go into my workplace tomorrow, I want to leave an imprint of faith. If I need a promotion, I am going to walk around that office tomorrow, and I'm going to silently inside pray as I take every step, praying, if this is the place where you want me to prosper, a promotion is going to happen in Jesus' name. And as we put our imprint of faith on those floors, I believe we're proving to God that we really, truly believe it with our action. Because in walking it out, I'm proving that I really, truly believe you are still working it out. Help me, Lord, to stay strong, to keep my faith in this time of preparation so that my presentation will draw others to your awesome love, your amazing grace, and your undeniable power. In Jesus' name, amen.
We hope you have enjoyed today's message. To download further resources, click on the resources icon. If this message has impacted your life, we would love to hear from you. So don't forget to join us next week for another inspiring message.